Welcome to this overview of Virtual Neuroscience 2021. This is a brief walkthrough of the key functions of this virtual experience. Please stay tuned for more in-depth information and videos on various features coming in the next couple weeks as you prepare for the meeting. Beginning November 3rd, all registrants will receive access to the virtual event website through email. Once you log in with your unique credentials, you can access all on-demand content. This includes symposia and mini-symposia presentations, poster recordings and slides, viewing exhibits, and graduate school booths. You can leave questions on any of the presentations or start to direct message or video chat with other attendees. You can also build out your profile and personal interests, which will result in a custom list of recommended sessions, posters, and exhibits based on your answers. There are many ways to search content on the site. Displayed here is a glimpse of the full schedule listing. Adding to your schedule is as easy as clicking the star. There will also be listings of curated itineraries, lists by sessions, and the ability to search by sub-theme. Once you click on a title, you'll see session details, including time and date of any live presentation. If there are on-demand presentations, as there will be for symposia, mini symposia, and posters, you will be able to view them here by individual presentation, which is linked next to the presenter's name, or by session playlist, which is linked at the bottom of the pop-out. From the session pop-out, you can open an individual presentation. Here again, you can watch the individual video or view the playlist. You can also see any additional resources that were uploaded. For each session and poster presenter, there will be a discussion. And again, this will be available starting November 3rd. You can leave a question for presenters at any time until November 30th when the site closes. Next, you see an example of an on-demand recording. On-demand recordings will display differently depending on how each presenter chose to record. This example shows a video that was recorded within the virtual event platform. Presentations recorded this way will allow attendees to change the presentation view. For example, you could enlarge or minimize the slides if you wanted the media feeds to appear differently. This shows the example of someone who recorded a video elsewhere and then uploaded the final video. Here you won't be able to change the presentation view. In all recordings, there is an option to turn on closed captioning. All presenters have the ability to review and edit the closed captioning of their own video, and this should improve the accuracy overall. Additionally, all presentations can be slowed down or sped up to 2 times faster, so you can control how you watch. Moving on to the live components. First, we see the live stream. Lectures, panels, symposia, and mini symposia panel discussions will all be live streamed. These are similar to webinars. Presenters will be in some combination of webcam and sharing slides. Attendees will be in listen-only mode. There will be a Q&A and discussion in every live stream. For many presentations, speakers will also be on in the discussion and able to answer your questions directly. All live streams will be recorded and available on demand through November 30th. Video chats will be used for poster discussions. These are more like Zoom meetings. All attendees in a video chat can be on webcam or in audio only. There is closed captioning, screen sharing, and a text chat in each of these. These are not recorded. This is one area of the virtual event that you have to be at live. Though you can view the posters, leave questions there, and reach out to individual authors throughout the meeting. Here's a glimpse of what the company exhibits and graduate fair booths look like. Check out each booth to get more information and check out their video chat hours. Each person will have a customized virtual experience page. Here you can access your profile, the schedule you build, the scavenger hunt, and recommended sessions, exhibitors, and other attendees to network with. These recommendations will be populated based on what you fill out in your profile. You can fill out your profile immediately upon logging into the site, and you can update it at any time through the conference. You will be able to select from all sub-themes and exhibitor categories, along with self-selecting ribbons and adding other personal preferences. These recommendations will then produce a list of suggested sessions, posters, exhibitors, and other attendees based on your interests. For more networking opportunities, you can search attendee profiles. The ribbons that are self-selected are searchable. For example, select the job seeker or hiring ribbons as a great way to connect with employment opportunities. You can also send direct messages to other attendees, and you can open up a one-to-one video chat at any time. You just need to have one person open their video chat, and then you can join in and talk right within the event website. Thanks for watching this walkthrough. Please stay tuned for more in the next couple weeks.